The history of math is our intellectual foundation for understanding science. This beautiful, awesome, amazing, wonderful science is our creative foundation for our imaginable futures. One key opens the door of our curiosity to science, just one key. That key was found on a 3.8 centimeter wide stone with six straight parallel red lines and three slightly curved diagonal lines. It is the oldest known drawing and dates back to over 73,000 years ago. Whether those lines were a drawing or mathematical scribblings, this small stone flake is our first example of our ancient ancestors' use of mathematics. Math is the foundation of everything in the language of nature. From math, we learned how to count, divide, multiply, and subtract in order to sell agriculture, add crops, divide it among the town's residents, and save for a rainy day. We analyzed the stars and we studied the curvature of the earth using geometry. This required math. Math, it's in our blood. So if you think you're not a math person, you are incorrect. Math has been in your family for millennia. You are a math person. Own up to it. Be proud. This is my show, Math Science History. It touches on the foundations that we stand on as it relates to science, as it relates to mathematics, and more importantly, as it relates to our future. Without our histories, we would not have promising futures. Without our histories, we would not be able to see the red flags of impending danger. Without our histories, we would not be able to understand our human potential. Our futures hold immense promise. In machine learning and artificial intelligence, we are on the verge of tremendous breakthroughs with platforms filled with open source frameworks, which allow people to implement algorithms without even coding. In supercomputing, we are approaching the ability to conduct superconductivity in near room temperatures. In the health industry, we are now on the verge of finding new strategies for treating eye disease by understanding how the retina projects proteins to different areas of our central nervous system. We have made so much exciting progress in science that it is astounding that we have come this far in such a short little time. Much of this is attributed to the foundations upon which we stand. From these foundations, we stand on the shoulders of giants, exceeding far beyond our predecessors' accomplishments. So how did all this begin? In East Africa's West Turkana, Kenya, archaeologists have found the Lumaquian stone tools that our ancestors created 3.3 million years ago. In South Africa, archaeologists discovered the Limbombo bone. In Central Africa, archaeologists found the Ishongo bone. Both bones are from a baboon's fibula and have markings that represent the process of counting. In the French Pyrenees caves, there are two beautiful carvings of bison that are almost perfectly proportional that date to 13,000 BCE. Each of the reliefs is a little over a half meter long, 45 centimeters in height, and 10 centimeters deep. These carvings show that even in the early Neolithic age, humans understood proportions. On the Tigris River, there are traces of 5,000-year-old living settlements that once filled nomadic tribes migrating towards southern Mesopotamia. This migration created an agricultural crisis. As a result, these nomads needed to monitor the extent of their agriculture. Urban development grew, and the government needed to feed the people. Leaders needed to figure out a way to feed the masses and make a profit. Because of this, math became prominent as workers counted crops and wrote on tablets like the proto-cuneiform administrative tablet found from around 3000 BCE. This tablet shows inscriptions for bills, receipts, calendars, and measurements. Even though some consider that money is the root of all evil, it's not. It was the root of our brilliance. Because these Sumerian tablets show a capacious understanding of financial mathematics. The Egyptian pyramids provide us with proof that in 2500 BCE, workers and slaves toiled for 85 years, through three generations, to build the colossal landmarks. borrowing the constructional idea from Mesopotamia's ziggurats, the Egyptians relied on mathematics and geometry to construct these larger and stronger pyramids. Finally, the upper areas of Mesopotamia in Babylon provide us our most significant mathematical developments from 1700 BCE. Cuneiform inscriptions on the rocks show us that our ancestors had an understanding of the Pythagorean theorem long before Pythagoras was even born. Mesopotamians etched this cuneiform tablet 4,000 years ago. Thus, 4,000 years ago, our ancestors were solving reciprocals and understanding fractions, linear equations, and ratios. These objects show us that math has guided us with every heartbeat. Nature humbles us with this realization that we are all mathematically innate creatures. The palpable evidence is overwhelming. We are part of this beautiful evolutionary machine of mathematics, taking part in the glorious dance of numbers. Math is tremendous because it encompasses our vast history while also making itself evident to us in the nature surrounding us, in the work of masterful artists, and in the delightful sound of music. Math filters through every corner of our lives. No doubt, math powered us through history and became the key to our future and the foundation of our sciences. Math, science, and history are the perfect trifecta to our futures, our past, and the brilliance within us. Thank you for watching Math Science History. And until next time, carpe diem. If you are interested in watching these videos a week in advance or listening to my podcast a week in advance, come on over to patreon.com/mathsciencehistory, where you can get access to the videos, the full transcript, additional math. Who doesn't love additional math, right? And all kinds of other interesting insights that I have from time to time about math, science, and history. Or if you would like to listen to the podcast publicly, you can find it on any of your favorite podcast channels. And for the videos, you can always find me here at YouTube, where I like to sing and talk about math. So until next time, carpe diem.